up, everyone? We're about to ready to go and get on the bike and take a ride down Old Church Road. Now this thing is hilly and hilly and hilly. That's why I love this road. During the video, I'm going to be talking about riding clubs because everybody emails me about these things and asks me about what I think about them. So I'm going to be talking about riding clubs and if I would join one, what I'm looking for in a riding club, the whole nine yards. So let's get going on the ride.
So lately, the subject of riding clubs had been coming up with those who've been emailing me. I figured I would address some of those emails here in the video. It's very true, I've always told people to either stay independent or join a riding club if they felt like wanting to be a part of something. I've also added that people should not join a motorcycle club if they're not ready for it. But most importantly, you should join a motorcycle rights organization. One of the major questions I've been getting regarding a riding club is, what do I perceive a riding club to be? The other question was, do I think riding clubs are a good place to go looking for brotherhood? To this question, the answer is simple. You can be an independent biker and find brotherhood almost anywhere. You don't need a patch or belong to something to find brotherhood, people. I'm actually amazed with how many people always think they need to be included in some type of organization to be considered a biker. To those, I suggest watching my series on independent bikers. Many of the questions I get sent can be found in those videos. Anyways, to the riding club question and how do I perceive what a riding club is. It's simple. It's a group that gets together and rides, parties, or gets involved in community activities. The true riding clubs usually wear a circular one-piece patch and most are not motorcycle specific. One of the things I really like about some of them. I'm one of those guys who don't care what you ride. Yeah. I know there's a split between road bikes and rockets in the scene, but to me, they both have two wheels. Don't care the make or style of the bike someone rides. Crap, I used to own rockets. So to say they shouldn't be included in a riding club, I would be a hypocrite. Truth be told, I think rockets are some pretty damn nice bikes. But moving on. A riding club should be just that, a riding club, not something disguised as a motorcycle club. Again, motorcycle clubs are something that requires a ton of time and commitment. A riding club should just be there to go riding and enjoying the scene without any of the politics. It's more laid-back type of an organization, or even some go by associations, by the way. The one thing that is for certain is a true riding club uses a one-piece backpatch without any state or city designation. Some might use the RC or riding club spelled out, but many nowadays do not use either. Some riding clubs or associations build in the charity they are supporting right into the patch. For example, Moose Riders. The Moose Riders are members of the Loyal Order of Moose, and on their patch, they have Moose Heart and Moose Haven. Two charities that are attached to the Moose, so they have it on their patch. The important thing to remember about a riding club, though, is it's just for fun. Most have men and women riders, and race don't figure in the membership. As far as dues are concerned, some riding clubs go by yearly dues or some go by monthly dues. The dues are usually broken up between the riding club and the charity they ride for. The dues going to the riding club are usually used for their national and regional runs and parties. Or they might even get a fund going for an injured or in need member. It all depends on the way the organization is set up and what their bylaws say. The one thing about riding club is nothing is mandatory. You participate when you like or you don't participate at all. Again, this type of organization, you get what you put into it. This is one of the major differences between a riding club and a motorcycle club. With a motorcycle club, you have to be active to keep your patch. A riding club is the total opposite. Basically, all you have to do is pay the dues each year to be considered in good standing, and that's it. Other advantages of a riding club is if they are big enough, you get member discounts on, say, car rentals, hotels. My earlier example, the Moose Riders, offers this. Though again, you have to be a member of the Moose to be a Moose Rider, so don't forget that. But back to the dues. Because I know many have asked me about this. Riding clubs usually charge for the patch. Most of the time they send it in a membership packet with stickers and stuff. Then they either charge a fee of about $25 to $50 a year for membership. Those who charge monthly dues usually charge about $10 to $20. That's really the highest I've ever seen one charge. Again, those who charge the monthly dues are usually the ones who hold big parties and rallies where everyone across the country or region comes from. Oh, some do set it up like A-Bait, where they have state coordinators, state boards, and finally districts within a state. It's funny. One of the questions I receive on this subject is, would I join a riding club? I always tell the person asking the question, maybe one day. First, I would have to find one that I like. For me to join a riding club, it would have to be a good purpose, has to be behind that. Something like contributing to Wounded Warriors or St. Jude's. Another thing, it would need to have a good active membership, meaning they actually got out there and ride and have get-togethers. I'm not interested in buying a patch or being a part of something where I would just send money into. Kind of defeats the purpose joining something if all that it does is sell patches to every Tom, Dick, and Harry and isn't active at all. Finally, it would have to be an all-male riding club. Sure, many riding clubs have women in them, but I'm just too set in my ways when it comes to a woman wearing the same patch as a man, riding club or motorcycle club. It's nothing against them, just how I was brought up in the life. So that's just my two cents on riding clubs. Hopefully the information helps you out, and I've answered some of the questions sent in to me on the subject, because I get quite a bit. Also, don't forget to check out the independent video series that I did, and a lot of those questions are answered about independent bikers and why it's great to just be independent and do your thing. So, until next video, stay safe and rock on, everybody!